back in the day. So what is my point? Where am I going with this? We have moved from Nokia 3310, which was a thing at the time, to iPhone 10. Like, how many people have iPhones in the house? Yeah. But why are we staying with the same curriculum that existed in the days of Nokia 3310? Why is the system still holding on to that curriculum? Why even the system has, we have upgraded ourselves to these iPhones and iPads and these devices that talk and communicate with each other, but the curriculum is still very much the Nokia 3310. And we don't bother for that. We are not asking ourselves why. These are questions that we need to think. We are now in a era where you can touch a button and text appears at your door. That is how much we have evolved as a people. But why is it that we're shoving down our kids the system or the concepts of Nokia 3310? And we're comfortable with that. We are not asking ourselves questions. I think that it's about time that these things change. As much as we are evolving, we should push the change. And perhaps it's already happening, because if we are having this conversation at all on a government platform, I think that's changes. We're close to change. And so the necessity of innovative thinking and skill alignment, why is this even necessary? You know? So there's a need for us to move with greater focus and urgency to upskill and develop human capital required to seize these opportunities require. Because if we don't yet know for sure how this thing is going to evolve. If anyone tells you that I know how the next 10 years are going to be like, they are lying, because no one knows how AI is going to evolve and affect the changes that are happening in the world. But one thing is clear, we need to start preparing for this uncertainty right now. And all stakeholders should be involved, which is happening right now, you know, like the poor people, the private sector, even lay people like me, standing here talking about skill curriculum. So that is actually something amazing and it's changing. You know, with my son, he's 10 years old, and the kind of information that I'm exposing him to on the internet is quite fascinating, to the point where he is asking me, like, Mommy, why are these things not taught in school? And so if a 10-year-old can look at things he sees on the internet, things he finds me doing, and ask the question, why are these things not taught in school? Then there is a problem with the education system. If the skills of the future, when you Google the top 10 skills of the future, you find out that creativity is right at the top. And there's no subject in school for creativity. But how do we develop that in kids? For me, I had bought a laptop for my son, and I did install for him a Photoshop, and basically told him, go on YouTube, watch videos on how to do graphic design. He wanted me to put him in a course on weekends where he can do graphic design. I said, no, learn on your own. Because I'm trying to teach him to be self-dependent when it comes to study. Because if you look at the world today, you will find out that most of the tech gurus are self-taught. So I don't want him to be in that space where he thinks that someone is going to solve the problems for him. No, and the more he is studying graphic design on his own, the more he is curious about what is happening, the more his creative juices are flowing. And the whole thing is to get him to that creative space. And this is a question I start to ask myself. Why are the subjects like graphic design? If creativity is going to be the thing in the future, if creativity is going to be the thing that robots cannot take away from us, why are subjects like graphic design missing in school curriculum? Why are subjects like animation? Kids know cartoon naturally, day after day. My son can draw amazing images, sometimes really weird images, out of his brain. If the school system could support things like that, these kids would become amazing. Why are things like that missing from school? Because now the things that he's naturally drawn at, when he goes to school, something else is being shut down his throat, and it kind of interferes with what he really wants to do. But not that it has to be in school. So the question then becomes, if the future is going to be aligned with creativity, shouldn't we expose our kids things that will make those creative juices flowing? Shouldn't the school system bring to the point where kids are not being taught what to think, but they're being brought to that place where they decide on what to think and they ask questions? Shouldn't we get to that point where we actually allow our kids to be able to decide what is it that they want and not just the school system telling them this is what you should do? Shouldn't we get to that point where we don't actually do the exams, but